Okay, it's preparing to live stream.
Oh yeah, there we go. It's saying I got it. So I got a message. It says that you're live. I'm gonna go look on your channel, Aya, just to make sure you're there so I can share it with our audience, okay?
I'm getting a message too. Meeting is now streaming live on YouTube.
Okay, I see it. Okay, I'm gonna go look. I see something. Okay, let's see what I see. There we go. We are live. It's working.
All right. I can see you. I can hear. Say something so I can tell if I hear you.
Hello.
All right. I can see you both. I can hear you.
Wonderful.
And we're live.
We're live, so you can start sharing your wonderful song.
Well. But the title of this one is Disbelief.
Okay.
Oh, the devil came down to Phoenix looking for souls to, looking for faith to eat. For the fear and faith of gullible souls makes up his wine and meat. And faith had gotten scarcer in these modern cynic years. Still, he thought he'd find an easy dinner here. Ho, 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 I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, you're not real. He took the shape of a preacher on the corner of the street, and he yelled hell and damnation at everyone he'd meet, describing hell and Satan in loving sharp detail. But only saw his finest efforts fail. Yo, ho, 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 I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, you're not real. Passers-by ignored him and kept on passing by. Only heckling teenage punks would stop and meet his eye. Give up, an old man told him, what is hell to fear after you've survived 10 summers here? Yo, ho, 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 I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, you're not real. So he put on his classic shape with the horns and hooves and tail. And he threw fireballs around the street. He howled and pranced and wailed. But folks just laughed. Great magic tricks. Those effects must be hard. And a son. And a talent agent handed him her card. Yo, ho, ho, ho. I disbelieve you. I disbelieve you. I disbelieve you, you're not real. A wise old Navajo shaman came up to him and said, the sweet blind faith you're looking for in this land is long dead. Our folk have learned the hard way to always know the score, and faith is not a virtue anymore. Yo, ho, 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 I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, you're not real. Just where you'll find good hunting, there's no place I can name, where life is soft and simple, and faith's an easy game. If faith can move a mountain, unfaith can tear it down. Old Scratch, I think you'd best get out of town. Yo, ho, 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 I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, I disbelieve you, you're not real. The devil looked at his shadow, and he saw it thin and gray. The force of all that disbelief was gnawing him away. So he ran back home and barred the door to wait for a better year, in hopes that he would someday no more hear. Yo, ho, 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 I disbelieve you. you. I disbelieve you. I disbelieve you. You're not real. I disbelieve you. I disbelieve you. I disbelieve you. You're not real.
Hey.
That was great.
Okay, I've got my books behind me. Just a batch of a quick collection right here. Anything else you can think of offhand?
Yes. Actually, I sent you a whole list of things. And interestingly enough, one of them was Lucifer. And I know that this devil and Lucifer are completely different beings. So I thought that would be a nice follow-up.
Interesting.
Okay, I'm going to have to do some hunting there. Because the Lucifer song that that John Simpson wrote is more of a metaphor. Hold on a minute.
That Lucifer is more like Prometheus and less like Satan.
Exactly. You find the right book.
Wants.
Hold on, let me see if I got the right book here.
Okay. See, Leslie, you haven't been checking your email because I sent you a whole list of songs.
Or else I hadn't gotten down that far, but the time you get caught up to me.
Wrong. Oh, book. You were behind on your email.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it doesn't. You know, I get hundreds of emails every damn day.
I know.
Hours to figure the damn things out. Let's see if it's in here. It's in the other book. It's in the other book. The one that's in my book bag. It's in the other book. Oh, hold on.
Oh, wow. I love all the paintings in the background. I was just noticing, like, some the one from the other day.
Yeah. And I don't know if you saw this one. It's my angel. And
oh, I love it.
Coffee painting.
It's coffee painting. That is so awesome. I need to revisit my coffee painting because I wasn't patient enough and it became coffee mountain blob.
So. Found it.
Good.
Now, by coincidence, Don Simpson just sent me a bunch more songs today.
Oh, really?
Right, which of course I've got in my email, not printed out. So,
yeah.
Oh, timing. Everything is timing. Yes. Let me teach you to wonder and worry. Permit me to tell you how to wage war. A creature's reach should exceed its grasp, or what is heaven for? I'll show you the way to take thought for tomorrow, to struggle for dreams and to hunger for more. A creature's sight should outrun its might, or what are the heavens for? Taste of the fruit of the tree that is knowledge of good and of evil and all the world's lore. Oh, creatures, thy thought should exceed what it's taught, or whom is heaven for? So come here and learn to become as the gods are. For I've got a wonderful secret to tell. All creatures reach should exceed its grasp. What else is heaven or hell?
Beautiful.
John Simpson.
Really? Wow.
Okay.
Julia, are you monitoring the chat in case somebody else makes?
Yeah, I've been looking and seeing. I'll look again. I don't see any comments yet, but please, if you would like to request a song from Leslie, it's here, so we have this grand opportunity.
Blushes, my blushes. Okay. Well, as long as I'm in this book. Be careful. This is my, generally my pagan book. And it contains a lot of songs that are not necessarily mine. For example, this is a poem by E.E. Cummings that I put a tune to ever so long ago. For any ruffian of the sky, your kingbird doesn't give a damn. For he's the soul of chivalry. His royal war cry is, I am in terror of his furious beak. As sweetly singing creatures know, cringes the hugest heartless hawk, and veers the vastest crafty crow. For murderers of high estate, your kingbird doesn't give a damn. Their tyrant creed is might makes right. His royal war cry is, I am to his mate and babes and friends. He loves because he cannot fear. You see it in the way he stands, and how he looks and leaps upon the air. Say that's an old, old E.E. Cummings poem. I'd like to know who he wrote it about.
I was trying to figure out the I am part.
There's enough for him to say, I exist. Yeah. Oh. And here's an old favorite of mine. Out of tune again already. There were three mates come from the west, their fortune to espy. And these three mates took a solemn oath that John Barleycorn must die. They buried him in three furrows deep, pile clods upon his head. Then these three maids took a solemn oath that John Barleycorn was dead. They let him lie for about 3 weeks while the drops from heaven did fall. Then little Sir John lifted up his head, and so did amaze them all. They let him stand till Midsummer's Day, till he looked both pale and wan. Then little Sir John grew a long, long beard, and so became a man. They've hired the men with the scythes so sharp to cut him off at the knee, and roll him and tied him about the waist. Oh, they served him barbarously. They've hired the men with the crab tree sticks to thresh him skin from bone. And the miller has treated him worst of all, for he's ground him between two stones. And that was the death of John Barleycorn, but he lived to tell the tale. For they bunged him into an oaken vat and called him home brewed ale. And the king, he could not keep his court, nor the huntsman wind his horn, nor the sailor sail, nor the plowman plow, without John Barleycorn.
Oh, that's very good.
To a pagan, that is a religious song. Okay, from the sublime to the ridiculous. Oh, yeah, if you noticed my Facebook page, I got a post up that my song Not the Way to Get Laid is now available.
Yeah, I saw that. That's by the cool. way, around 9/11, you know, I was promoting Flight 93 that we have a recording on my channel of it. Mm. And somebody asked, where could they buy the CD? Do you know?
I don't know if it's ever been recorded. Get a hold of Mary Creasy. I think she made a house recording of it. And well, if anybody knows, she would. She's my recording guru.
I mean, it's on the Lock and Load CD. Is that CD still available?
Yes, yes. The Lock and there are some. Copies lying around. I think I've got a few.
Okay, so maybe I should tell them that they should contact you if they want to buy a copy.
Or better still, Mary Creasy.
Or Mary Creasy, okay.
All right. Hold on now. I was going to. I swear I've been recorded on so many convention albums and house albums and house tapes that I've no idea what of my stuff is recorded or not anymore. That's why I voiced it off on Mary.
Okay,
if it's on the Lock and Load album, there are a few copies left. And what with the wonders of modern technology, you can always, it's very easy to make bootlegs.
Okay. Well, we want you to get the royalties.
Again, Mary.
Okay.
Yeah, she's our best avenue channel. Unless you're going to join Bandcamp like Mark did.
I know nothing of these things. The techie end of recording is not my forte. Somebody else has got to do that and keep track of it. So generally it's Eli who does that kind of thing and Mary who keeps track of it.
Okay. All right.
Put stuff on them. But anyways, I was saying from the sublime to the ridiculous, from John Barleycorn to Jack the Slob to Venus prayed. Mary, Mary, pray. Grant this night I shall get laid. Mary, Mary, laid. Tonight I shall get laid. The goddess said, that shall I do. Mary, Mary, do. But first I ask three things of you. Mary, Mary, you. I ask three things of you. Go clean your teeth and bod and hair. Hair, merry, merry hair. And change your weak old underwear. Wear, merry, merry, wear your weak old underwear. Although by now it's pretty strong old underwear. Just put on clothes that flatter you. You, merry, merry you. A clean t-shirt and jeans will do. Merry, merry do. A clean t-shirt will do. And when a maid you would impress, press, merry, merry press. Pray do not drool down her chest. Merry, merry chest. Do not drool down her chest. Jack replied, "No, thank you, ma'am, 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 merry, merry, ma'am. Send me a girl who'll take me as I am, 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 merry, merry, am, will take me as I am." Venus said, "I'll tell you what, what, merry, merry, mutt. Though I should kick your lazy butt, but, merry, merry, bet, should kick your lazy butt. Perhaps 'twould be more fitting far, 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 merry, merry, far, to send you a girl who'll take you as you are. Are, are, merry, merry, are, will take you as you are. Pray go at once to the city zoo, 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 merry, merry, zoo. There you will find the girl for you, 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 merry, merry, you. The girl, you'll find the girl for you." There he went with hopes held high, 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 merry, merry, high, until the ape house he came nigh, 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 merry, merry, nigh, the ape house he came nigh. There a maiden him did view, 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 merry, merry, view, and she was struck with passion true, 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 merry, merry, true, struck with passion true. Her hair was thick, her looks were free, 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 merry, merry, free. Indeed, she was a lovely chimpanzee, zee, zee, merry, merry, zee, a lovely chimpanzee. She leaped the fence ere he could run, 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 merry, merry, run, and seized him boldly by the bun, 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 merry, merry, bun, she seized him by the bun. She dragged him swiftly to her lair, 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 merry, merry, lair, for all that I know, he may still be there, 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 merry, merry, there, he may still be there. So lazy swains, remember this, 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 merry, merry, this. You should not get the goddess pissed, 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 merry, merry, pissed. You should not get her pissed. That's the flip side of not the way to get laid.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Yeah. So I heard that you were having some issues with people of that persuasion. What are they called?
First I've heard of it.
Yeah. What are they called, Julia?
Men?
No, not all men. Those men, lazy men,
like gigolos.
Somebody warned me that they didn't want to put my lyrics up on.
Men who never date.
Some incels.
The incels. Yeah. Okay.
Right.
I had to explain to me just what an incel was.
We did an episode on it. You should watch it.
Well. And I was rather astonished to find there's a whole culture thereof.
There is. They do the red pill, and once their eyes are open, oh my God, you know, yes, they're quite the interesting bunch.
Oh, they're the new ethnic group that the Wokey-Dokes want to defend. So even the Wokey-Dokes won't touch a bunch that stupid. Okay. Now, in my book, if you're too damn lazy to bother to learn what it is that women like, and too lazy to bother to do it, then you're not fit to breed. Get out of here.
And I don't think they want to anyway. I think they just want to be left alone and die out. I think that's the incel's ultimate dream, actually.
Let them. Anybody who's that too lazy to mate. Does not deserve to breed.
Good point.
Yeah. Okay, here's one that was written by my old friend Alana. She's dead now.
Oh.
Vegan buddy. She was one of the first people to, first folks to welcome me when I first came to the Valley. Though these many years ago. And she ran the local pagan group for a while. Well, till she died. You know. And let's see. And this is about the pagan community in general. Oh, come on. No, what key is it? I will rise like a seed that is growing. I will rise like a wind that is blowing. I will rise. Though you tried your best to burn me and destroy me with your lies, I am stronger than your hatred. I will rise. I will rise. I will rise like the curling smoke. I will rise like the sacred oak. I will rise. You did your best to stop me. Goddess knows you tried, but I'm stronger than your hatred. I will rise. I will rise like an eagle of flying. I will rise. There is no true death in dying. I will rise. You tried your best to silence me, but my existence testifies. I am stronger than your hatred. I will rise. I will rise. Hear me softly drumming. I will rise. And know that I am coming. I will rise. Like a legendary phoenix, from the ashes to the skies, I've returned and I am millions. I will rise. Alana. Oh, my. I sometimes wonder how long. Gee, I've been in the Valley 20 years, but it's amazing how many of my old friends have disappeared. Anyway.
The longer we live, the more friends we lose that way.
You gotta go out and get more. This is getting ridiculous. Okay, Inter Diana. One here whose team I don't know. Some working songs like how to create a shield. Oh, one by an old one by Ian Corrigan. What key is this in? Oh, now where's it easier to sing this? Oh, come on. Mm-hmm. Same key, but it's easiest to sing in What the Hell I'll Do It. It's by Ian Corrigan. As I rode out one morning upon All Hallows Eve, 'twas there I met with a horned man, and I asked of him his leave. His hooves were of the kettle iron, his horn sprang like the bow, and I was caught up in his pack with a wild hunt for to go. Rode and raged through the autumn glade, and the earth grew cold and chill, for everywhere his wild hunt rode, we worked his icy will. We rode through village, field, and town, and shudders drew in fear, for before us ran the horned man, our winter king so dear. And then, at last, by starlight, we came to that wild glade, where we trod the ancient circle, and the winter spell was made. And there I saw my father, 10 years and 7 dead, and he did bear the icy spear, and wear horns upon his head. But all things come unto their end, so from that place I passed. And when to Onoven I do go, I will ride with him at last. The horned man will bless us all, as sure as you are born. So raise your cup and sup it up, all hail to Hoof and Horn.
We have a comment from someone in Ecuador that says, "Hola, soy de Ecuador. Me gusta su programa." So she likes the program, is what she's saying.
All right. Glad you like. Enjoy. I'm sure there are plenty of pagan river, old pagans hanging out in Ecuador too. Okay. And here's one for. I wrote my old pal, Joe Bethencourt. And I started singing it as started writing it at his funeral, his memorial service. I got one verse and chorus done, and I asked for inspiration for the rest of it from the local community, fans. And I got some. This is a very Arizona pagan song.
Interesting. Should be fun.
High desert wind won't blow the songs away. They pace the streets of Tombstone with Doc Halliday. Long as they blow, the stronger souls can stay. High desert wind, come blow again. For half the year it's blowing dust and blazing sun fire heat. Then twice a year the solstice rains flood gully, field, and street. Earth and water, air and fire, as any wise soul could desire. Shaped by ancient songs upon the wind. Sung before and now be sung again. High desert wind won't blow the songs away. They pace the streets of Tombstone with Doc Halliday. Long as they blow, the stronger souls can stay. High desert wind, come blow again. The sun burns down on shattered rock like fire from the sky. The stars at night burn like a dream that no one can deny. Light and darkness, stars and moon, petroglyph, petroglyph, and ancient rune. secrets whispered softly on the wind, sung before and coming round again. I, desert wind, won't blow the songs away. They pace the streets of Tombstone with Doc Holliday. Long as they blow, the stronger souls can stay. I, desert wind, come blow again. The wind that spreads the flowers' call, the pollen and the seeds, bears life throughout the desert lands that serve the spirit's needs. Battered clouds in glowing herds paint the sky in ancient words of powers from the oldest days of men. Welcome in, old friend, come sing again. I, desert wind, won't blow the songs away. They pace the streets of Tombstone with Doc Holliday. Long as they blow, the stronger souls can stay. I, desert wind, come blow again. I, desert wind, come blow again.
Very nice.
Yeah. Okay. What else we got in here? Here's another one by Kay Madsen from East Lansing, the East Lansing Spinsters Guild. It's set up on an album called Iolus, which is almost impossible to find these days. But the song is still making the rounds in the pagan community. Come on. I am a bold and a pagan soul, a rattling through this land. I judge the world by my own lights, and I come by my own hand. And if you ask me where I learned to live so recklessly, my skin, my bones, my heretic heart are my authority. My mother was a spinner of tales, my father a dreaming man, and I have swung on the dragon's tongue and danced on holy land. I have sung the seed up out of the ground and the birds down from the tree. My skin, my bones, my heretic heart are my authority. Once I was bound, but now I've gone away from the faithful fold, from those who preach that holiness is to do as you are told. The whole law and scripture, priest and prayer, have all instructed me. My skin, my bones, my heretic heart are my authority. They tell me Jesus loves me, but I think he loves in vain. He must go unrequited, for on me he has no claim. For the man who would command me must wear horns and let me be. My skin, my bones, my heretic heart are my authority. Thank you. Then while I breathe this glorious air, an outlaw I'll remain. My body will not be subdued, and I will not be saved. And if I cannot shout it out loud, I'll sing it secretly. My skin, my bones, my heretic heart are my authority.
Great, I love it.
I know it can be found. It's somewhere up on the internet, but I don't know where. It's called Heretic Heart. And
by who again?
Heretic Heart.
Okay, but who did you say it was written by?
From what I can see, K Madsen.
Okay, I found it. I just typed it into YouTube, and I see an 11-year-old recording called Heretic Heart, and yeah, it has like 7,000 views. So I think it says pagan song.
Yep, definitely.
That must be it. Yeah, it's very Celtic. It sounds like, right?
Yes, and of course, very heretical.
Well, I have a friend that watches my YouTube channel. She'd probably like this because she always is talking about Odin, and she's interested. I guess she's a pagan, so she'd probably love what you're talking about.
Yeah. Anybody who talks about Thor and Odin or the Great Earth Mother and that sort. There's definitely a pagan. Here's another. Okay, this is coming around at the right time of the year. This is called Hallow's Dirge, written by Krista Hayden Landon and an old buddy from college who became a Unitarian minister and founded the pagan branch of the Unitarian Church.
I did not know there was one.
Yeah, that's what I found out a few years ago, is the Unitarian Church in Riverside, they have pagans, they have Buddhists, they had a little bit of everything. It was very interesting.
Yeah, the Council of Unitarian Universalist Pagans, or CUPS, that was founded by my old buddy, Krista, and she officiated at my wedding with Rasty.
Oh, okay, that's wonderful. That was not too long ago.
No, almost 10 years now.
I don't know. Do you guys know who Batuo is? But because Batuo is saying in the comments that they want to help that song that you just played when I said it only has 7,000 views. So I thought that, I don't know who that is. Is that somebody in the Phil King community?
Phil King or pagan? There's a lot of overlap, as you might guess.
Very cool. Well, hi, Batuo.
Anyway, here's the one that my old buddy Krista wrote. If I can get this thing to right there. It's called Hallow's Dirge. Hear my voice, O Lord of Hades. Salve my sorrow, light is fading. Muse, add thine eloquence to mine. End of year and end of harvest. Burnt the fields where life abounded. All that remains is memory's wine. Where the roses of the summer, where the light wind leaves have fallen, where are the works that I have done? As the sowing, so the reaping. Turn the year to joy or weeping. The hour of weighing grain has come. wine distills the sun of summer. Now I wait and watch and slumber. Vigil to keep beneath the ground. Yet my eyes see light and darkness. Yet my soul knows truth and shadow. Yet I attend upon the spring. Deep in silence speaks the wisdom. Let me treasure autumn's season. Time to reflect, to dream and plan. Burn the weeds and fill the grain bin. Rise the shades to whisper longing. Earth rends her garments, mourns the sun.
Done.
You know, here's an old Australian song. It's supposed to be a horror story, but I believe the poet who wrote the original poem didn't realize how much he was giving away. Lie down, my newly married wife. Lie easy as you can. You're young and ill-accustomed yet to sleeping with a man. The snow was deep, the moon was full, as it shone on the cabin floor. His young bride rose without a word and ran barefoot through the door. He up and followed fast and sure, and an angry man was he. But his young bride was nowhere in sight, and only the moon shone free. He followed her track through the new deep snow, calling out loud her name. Only the dingoes in the hills howled back at him again. Then the hair stood up along his neck, and his angry mind was gone. For where the 2-foot track gave out, a 4-foot track went on. Her nightgown lay upon the snow, as it might on her own bed sheet, and the tracks that led from where it lay were never of human feet. First he started walking back, then he began to run, and his quarry turned all in her track and hunted him in turn. His empty bed still waits for him as he lies in her crimson tide. Beware, beware, oh trapper men, beware of a grisly bride. See. Words by John Manifold, Australian.
That kind of reminds me of A Shadow in the Bright Bazaar.
Right, Deer Hunter.
Yeah.
When it was recorded, it was a... Recorded, Terry Lee wanted to change the name to Golden Eyes, but...
Right.
Because the title gave too much away. It's in the other book. It's in the other book. Damn it!
It was in the Horse Tamer's Daughter book, wasn't it?
Yes. Oh. There's a song that. Here's a folk by Joe Elcott. I have it, sorry, to take out on my on my hymn to Thor. Hey, Thor, god of thunder, master of the winds of the western world, set your hammer down, we're tired of the lightning and of storms. Often have we sung your ancient, master of the winds of the western world, now I think we'd like to recant, tired of the lightning and of storms. Hey, Thor, god of thunder, master of the winds of the western world, set your hammer down, we're tired of lightning and of storms. Last year we had a drought to haunt us, master of the winds of the western world, now it seems you want to taunt us, tired of a lightning and of storms. Hey, Thor, lord of thunder, master of the winds of the western world, set your hammer down, we're tired of a lightning and of storms. I know we may sound like Grinches, master of the winds of the western world, but we've had over 40 inches, tired of lightning and of storms. Hey, Thor, lord of thunder, master of the winds of the western world, set your hammer down, we're tired of a lightning and of storms. It's really not that hard a riddle, master of the winds of the western world, Give us 1 year in the middle, tired of lightning and of storms. Hey, Thor, god of thunder, master of the winds of the western world, set your hammer down, we're tired of lightning and of storms. I can see his point. Let me see what else I got in this part of the book.
I do have to say, I think even though we usually do our regular time at 6:45, we seem to be getting more activity around this time of night. It's later. And I think more people are up on a Friday night. Just saying. Interesting.
Okay.
Good to know.
Well, as long as my fingers hold out.
Well, if you're getting tired, don't worry about it, Leslie. I'm just commenting on, like, we've had a good response and there's been some good comments in the chat.
Okay. Get off.
Aw.
Get off. Streak, move. Yeah. Okay. Well, that. Example of folk process. Way back when, Misty Lackey wrote the words for a song called "Winds Four Quarters," and I put the music to it. And simply as a pagan song, it was quite nice as it was. But a friend named Kenita Watson, Kenneth and Kenita, thought it was a great song for ritual use, and they took and made it into a circle casting song.
Oh, interesting.
One of the best I've ever seen, for that matter. You can use it for either winding the circle or unwinding it, depending on what order you sing it in. Kitty, get off. Go on. Eastern wind, blow cool, blow clear. Cleanse our minds of worldly woes, cleanse our tools for working here, cleanse our power as it grows. Maid whose love has never ceased, aid and guard us from beast. Winds four quarters, air and fire, earth and water, hear our desire. Guard all sides from threats unknown, maiden warrior, mother and crone. Southern wind, blow hot, blow hard. Charge our tools with flames of old. Southern wind, be guide and guard. Keep the power well controlled. If the hazards should require, sister, shield us with your fire. Winds four quarters, air and fire, earth and water, hear our desire. Guard all sides from threats unknown, maiden warrior, mother and crone. Western wind, blow wet, blow warm, swell below and spray above. As our will takes shape and form, Mother, guide us with your love as you hold us to your breast. Bring us comfort from the west. Winds four quarters, air and fire, earth and water, hear our desire. Guard all sides from threats unknown. Maiden warrior, mother and crone. Northern wind, blow clear, blow cold. Guard our circle round in stone. All intruders bind and hold. Shroud and shield us, ancient crone. You who rule both death and birth, lend us power from the earth. Winds four quarters, air and fire, earth and water, they're our desire. Guard all sides from threats unknown. Maiden warrior, mother and crone. And there's the second half, which is for taking down a circle.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, the verse. Northern wind, blow clear, blow cold. Though the stones wear down to dust, we preserve through years untold perfect love and perfect trust. May the seeds that we have grown bear good fruit when they have grown. Crone and mother, warrior maid, thank you for your steadfast aid. Farewell winds, so fierce, so fair, earth and water, fire and air. Western wind, blow warm, blow wet, though your tide may ebb away, you are with us even yet. You are welcome if you stay. May the works you helped us bond spread like ripples on a pond. Crone and mother, warrior maid, thank you for your steadfast aid. Farewell winds, so fierce, so fair, earth and water, fire and air. Southern wind, blow hard, blow. Southern wind, blow hard, blow hot. From your embers we shall take all the works that we begot. Tempered tools you've helped us make. May the works that we have wrought bring the good that we have sought. Crone and mother, warrior maid, thank you for your steadfast aid. Farewell winds, so fierce, so fair, earth and water, fire and air. Eastern wind, blow cool, blow clear, though your breeze may die away, your return is always near. Mist of morning, breath of May. Sweep the pathways as we go. Light our way, O Eastern glow. Crone and mother, warrior maid, thank you for your steadfast aid. Farewell winds, so fierce, so fair, earth and water, fire and air. The winding and the unwinding.
That is really neat. Wow. And we've been getting more comments. People are saying that they're happy to see you again, hear from you again, and hear your song. So,
yeah.
Glad to be here. It's just a question of timing and getting the machinery to work.
Well, you got here, so I think it's working out pretty great.
Yeah, let's take advantage of it as long as it lasts.
How about Circles? Do you ever sing that song, you know, in days gone by when the world was much younger?
That sounds interesting. I want to hear that.
So if I've got it in this book, which I'm not sure.
It's to the tune of Windmills.
I know, if I can just find the words. I've got three books this size, plus the Kipling.
Come on. Well, I know how it starts. It's in days gone by, when the world was much younger, men wondered at spring, born of winter's cold night, wondered at the games of the moon and the sunlight. They saw there the lady and the lord of all night.
And round it went, round turns the good earth. It must turn. Here it is, here it is.
Okay.
All right. Let me take a hit off my... I'm getting dehydrated here.
Oh, sure.
And some throat cleaner.
So anyway, one of the commenters says that they came across you at Clan O'Carrigan's camp on Willow Point at Pinsick. It's actually Think Beforehand, and she played well into the night. It was wonderful. And she also, somebody said, you know, it is impossible to hear too much of Leslie Fish. So yeah, your fans are all kind of here.
Thank you. I believe that was a Pinsick ward. It's been 10 years since I went to my last Pinsick. I think wow. I was at my last Estrella 8 years ago.
Were these outside at night or was it inside? Like,
no, it was out in the campsite. I took my guitar, my books.
So you're near the campfire? Oh my gosh. That's exciting. I like that.
I dragged my guitar and my book bag from camp to camp to camp.
I miss camping and campfires. I used to think I didn't like it as a kid, but I don't know. I kind of miss that sort of thing. It's neat.
And a nice thing about being a bard is you're welcomed at every camp. They usually had scotch to keep me powered up to go to the next camp. I ran on liquid fuel.
Cool.
Here we are. And my strings are getting out. In days gone by, when the world was much younger, men wondered at spring, born of winter's cold night, wondered at the games of the moon and the sunlight, and saw there the lady and lord of all light. And around, turns the good earth. All things must change as the seasons go by. We are the children of the Lord and the Lady, whose mysteries we know, but we'll never know why. In all lands, the people were bound to the good earth, plowing and sowing as the seasons declared, waiting to reap of the rich golden harvest, knowing her laugh in the joys that they shared. Through Flanders and Wales and the green hills of Ireland, kingdoms of England and Scotland and Spain, circles grew up all along the wild coastline to work for the land in the sun and the rain. Circles for healing and working the weather, circles for knowing the moon and the sun, circles for laugh, for thanking the Lord and the Lady, circles for dancing, the dance never done. And we reach for the stars in the heavens, still live in the light of the Lord and the Lady. The greater the circle, the more the love grows. So around and around and around turns the good earth. All things must change as the seasons go by. We are the children of the Lord and the Lady, whose mysteries we know, but we'll never know why. That's the one. Is that the one?
Yeah, that's the one. And I don't know why, but it says that we're turning our backs on the meadows and groves.
Well, considering this was when this was written, which is a while back, I can see that people thought that chasing technology, we were turning away from the needs of the planet. It's easy to see. All right. Circles, circles. Boy. Some of these pages have been turned so often they're soft as velvet.
Wow.
Well, maybe they're like parchment.
Yeah, are they made out of parchment?
No, they're just plain, plain old typing paper.
It just softens, yeah, probably because of your wearing away part of the upper texture. Mm-hmm. Newest thing is everybody wants to come to the library and use the old typewriter. It just surprised me. But people are really excited to do that lately. Like typewriters are kind of having, and these writers, like they're using typewriters again. I was like, oh, that's so interesting.
Makes sense. I mean, it's a good electric typewriter, or even a good light manual. It's totally independent from the internet. Nobody can see on what you're writing. A push the wrong button will not make everything vanish.
it's still there. It's tangible. You can.
And nobody can peek in on what you're writing.
Yeah, good point.
I can see the point, which is why I have a couple of old IBM Selectrics stashed away somewhere. Not of them workable, but enough of them to put parts enough together to make one whole typewriter, if I can get around to it. Oh, yeah. Anyway, this one was written by Tracy Blackstone Zimmer. She's Marion Zimmer Bradley's sister-in-law.
Oh.
And Jolly Pagan. And she plays the classical Irish harp, the portable one. And she has many a tale to tell of her adventures while visiting Britain with that harp. Anyway, this is her Hymn to the Morrigan, which is the battle gods, the battle goddess. Come, thou lady battle bright, lady of ravens, hear us now. Come, thou queen of dark and light, lady of ravens, hear us now. Bright the sword and dark the foe, lady of ravens, hear us now. Dark the night within the soul, lady of ravens, hear us now. Let thy glory light our way, lady of ravens, hear us now. Armored all in bright array, lady of ravens, hear us now. Strike the foe that all may see, lady of ravens, hear us now. Burning blade of victory, lady of ravens, hear us now. Dark the turning of the year, lady of ravens, hear us now. We are done with hope and fear, lady of ravens, hear us now. Nothing stands but will to win, lady of ravens, hear us now. Sing the wordless hymn within, lady of ravens, hear us now. Lady of ravens, hear us now.
So we have more people in the comments. Mike says it looks like it's good that Leslie came back on. And then we heard from Think Beforehand that Freedom of the Snow is one of her favorites, and also The Day It Fell Apart.
Oh, yeah, I like that one. The Day It Fell Apart.
In this book. If not, then I know where it is. Freedom of the Snow, yeah. Okay. It's in the other book. It's in the other book. I'm not sure just which one, but it's in the other book. Hold on, I gotta get up. Jump down, turn around, take a bail apart.
I don't think she's played the songs yet. You haven't played those two songs, right, Leslie?
No, she's working on it.
Patience. Freedom of the snow. You gotta jump down, turn around, speak to the button. Jump down, turn around. Jump down, turn around. How did I go hunting for the filth books? Jump down, turn around, take a bail a day. Oh, Lordy, take a bail a button. Oh, Lordy, sing a bail a day. Are we in this one? I think, yeah.
And The Day It Fell Apart is another one they mentioned.
Yes.
But I don't want to bombard you, I'm sorry.
I don't know if the I don't know if the camera is showing just quite how big these books are.
Yeah. I can tell. I mean, they look pretty voluminous, we'll say that.
And heavy.
Yeah, they're about that. Three, four.
Who needs to go to the gym? You just need to work with Leslie Fish and carry her songbooks around, you know?
Hey, don't laugh. I've got an awful lot of aspiring young fans to work their passage by carrying my book bag for me.
That's what I'm saying. Like, they don't, why would they need to go to the gym? They could help you out.
Another thing, because by toting my bag around for me, We got to go to some of the wildest parties.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Sounds better than gym anyway. I'm just saying, it sounds more interesting.
Yeah. Since I got married anyway, well, not to mention since the convention scene slowed down, I've been less likely to take the take my baggage toters to bed, but what the hell, I can still go to some weird parties. Okay. We were 20 pampered maidens under dormitory glass, gossiping about boyfriends, dates, and clothes. We glanced the tasteful windows at the growing storm outside, and never once took measure of the snows. Long past the time of night, we found no morning light. Blizzard covered all the world we'd known. Beyond all reach of law, we looked around and saw the Ice Age come to find us all alone. Cancel my salvation, give me leave to go back to the freedom of the snow, of the snow. Back to the freedom of the snow. As darkness, cold, and blizzard closed around our cringing cave, we wore our furs for better things than show. We melted snow for water when the pipes and the fuel lines froze, and thanked the gods for the stores of food below. The furnace coughed and died, we lit a fire and cried, we didn't have the wood to last a day. So we played a hand or three, and the high card fell on me, so I took an axe and went to find a way. Cancel my salvation, give me leave to go back to the freedom of the snow, of the snow. Back to the freedom of the snow. I found a tree blown over where the driveway used to be, and the axe moved swift and easy as a flame. I wasn't cold or weary, it was strange to be so free. Then out of the dark that junkie came. He didn't seem to know I was a changeling of the snow, not the easy peacetime girl he thought he'd found. The axe swung clean and high, and it caught him through the eye. And I took my wood and left him on the ground. Cancel my salvation, give me leave to go back to the freedom of the snow, of the snow. Back to the freedom of the snow. We camped about that story as we dreamed about that story as we camped beside the fire. We sang it while we hunted through the day. Until the hour our sentries saw the snowplow clear the road, and our families came to chase the spell away. So go back to your pantyhose, go lean on some man's arm, go forget that you were ever strong or free. But in dreams I see them still, the blizzard on the hill, the fireplace and the fire axe and the tree. Cancel my salvation, give me leave to go back to the freedom of the snow, of the snow. Back to the freedom of the snow.
That's so good.
Beautiful.
At least a partially true story, and I will so won't say which parts aren't.
That's okay. You reserve the right to do that.
It's been a few years, but I don't know if the statute of limitations is up. And the other one was, the day it fell apart?
Yeah, that's right.
All right. There's another one I want to do next. Okay. Similar situation writ larger. Just a little general hospital in a little factory town. The board put me in charge for mainly keeping prices down. I hadn't touched a patient since 1982. But the day of the explosion, I remembered what to do. At 11 in the morning, we all heard the factory blow. The blast took out the windows and the shrapnel fell like snow. We could get no help from out of town for half a day or more. We had near 1,000 casualties and beds for 94. And can you keep your head, your backbone, or your heart? We all found out the answer on the day it fell apart. It was worse than combat medicine. Supplies were draining fast. Bandages ran out and antiseptics wouldn't last. I took all the able-bodied I could catch inside the door and made them help the doctors or go scrounge supplies and more. I invented laws to tell them, saying in such emergency, forget your usual job and boss, your orders come from me. I sent the cops to commandeer anything in reach, food or disinfectant, cloth or alcohol or bleach. And can you keep your head, your backbone or your heart? We all found out the answer on the day it fell apart. The janitor ran cleanup squad, the cook maintained supplies. The garbage man removed the ones who died before our eyes. The clerks burned all our papers to boil water on the fire. For sterilizing instruments as the body count went higher. A local health food herbalist brought everything he can. The painkillers were useful and the poultices weren't bad. A smacking cocaine pusher handed us his whole supply. The quality was lousy, but a few more didn't die. And can you keep your head, your backbone, or your heart? We all found out the answers on the day it fell apart. We did triage in the parking lot, ranked minor, major, grave. A sad-eyed fireman gave the stroke to those we couldn't save. Then sometime in the chaos, a director wandered in to tell us we were breaking rules, what trouble we'd be in. But if we'd swear the factory was not the fire's cause, and the harm was accidental, he'd forget the broken laws. The staff sneaked up and grabbed him and tied him to a door. And he gave them blood transfusions till he hadn't any more. And can you keep your head, your backbone, or your heart? We all found out the answer on the day it fell apart. When that day was over, and we'd saved all that we could, we saw that law and politics would hang us where we stood. We'd saved 800 lives, but shattered all authority. I told them, people, save yourselves, put all the blame on me. I took my books and instruments and a few supplies beside. Packed my car and ran away to open countryside. So now I live an outlaw, condemned by righteous men. But for all the lives I saved that day, I'd do it all again. And can you keep your heart, your back, can you keep your head, your backbone or your heart? We all found out the answer on the day it fell apart. Yes, can you keep your head, your backbone or your heart? You'll all find out the answers on the day it falls apart. The day it falls apart.
That's a very libertarian song.
I think even a little further out for libertarians.
Anarchist, okay.
Yeah, the anarchists. Oh, yeah, that the Pink Lady Liberty. She posts some pretty anarchist stuff.
Unfortunately, the only anarchist party I've ever seen anywhere near a polling booth is the party at the Wobblies used to throw every New Year's Eve. The anarchist party roars on loud and hearty. That's Kelly passed out on the floor. There's Kathy who's singing and Chrissy who's clinging to something that vaguely resembles a door. I'm not sure anymore. What a grand old party this is. Yeah, it's got a different definition of the term. Okay, I'm going to do one more. My fingers are beginning to get, my fingertips are turning purple.
Okay, no, I mean, one more is good, I think.
Well, all right. You do one more, and then I'm going to have to cut out, I'm afraid, because I'm getting out.
Okay. All right.
Getting late.
How about we do it again next month, but we start a little bit earlier, okay?
Yeah, and with enough warnings in advance. And that I can at least figure out how to work this damn machine. Okay. It's getting crowded here, the air's getting bad. The noisy politics are making me mad. I want some distance, I want to see sky. Come on, baby, let's fly. There's a big space station flying high in the night. Let's go get on the very next flight. Turn off the gravity and let us through. I want to dance on the ceiling with you. I want to dance on the ceiling. I want to dance on the ceiling. I want to dance on the ceiling. I want to dance on the ceiling with you. Kick off your shoes and dance in the skies. Stand back and watch the full earth rise. Dance like a flame in the free, free fall. We won't weigh nothing at all. We can dance, fly all night and never come down. Leap tall buildings with a single bound. We can dance up there like we never could do. I wanna dance on the ceiling with you. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling with you. Drink champagne from a squeezable ball. look at the world and see it all. We'll have the time, we'll have the place, dancing in outer space. Stars all around us and in your eyes, we can swear that love never dies. You can tell that my love is true when I'm dancing on the ceiling with you. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling. I wanna dance on the ceiling with you. I wanna dance on the ceiling with you.
Yay.
That is great.
Thanks. Well, hey, it's nearly 10:30 where I am. Okay, we've been at it 2 hours. That's not bad.
I think we did pretty good, Leslie. Thank you for coming back on.
Yeah. I mean, it takes practice to work up to where I can sing all night. You know?
Okay. All right. Well,
we get more conventions, more folk sings. Yeah.
Let me see when next month we could do this.
Did you record this, didn't you?
Yeah, it's recorded.
Yeah, it's live, and people are commenting right now. They love it, and they want to know when you're on again next month, and I'm telling them, I guess, that you can be if we can schedule it and know in advance.
Yeah,
so.
And there's some, a little more planning and more preparation and more fussing with machines beforehand.
Okay, but you need to check your email. I'll send you an email, and you need to check it. But I'm thinking the 20th. If we don't have anything else on the 22nd.
22nd next month?
Yeah.
Well, I've got to prepare. By that time, all I have to prepare for is Halloween.
You can dress up as a pumpkin?
What I do for Halloween is rather weird, but that's for later.
Okay.
All right. We'd love to hear about it. So I've got it tentatively as the 22nd of October. Okay. I have to check and make sure that I don't have anything else lined up, but I don't have it on this calendar.
Well, my schedule's loose. Tell me when.
Did we have something on the 22nd? I don't think so. I don't think so. Let me.
Yeah, because I think the 29th is Kate's.
Yeah. I think you're right. Let me.
To me, don't get too close to Halloween.
So. Okay, well, you can prepare.
Did you say that you were doing the Jean Graham one on the 22nd, Aya?
Oh, let me check.
Because I'm just looking at my calendar real quick. I just want to make sure I didn't. Maybe I put it in for the wrong
date. No, you could be right. Let me just check.
Whatever. You guys decide. Get a hold of me.
Well, I mean, the only problem is that it was so hard to get a hold of you today. And
yeah, we want to, like, lock it in.
So let me.
I might have put that in wrong, but just check real quick before we.
Let me know in a week.
Okay, hold on. So I had a group chat with Jean and Jacqueline, and you're right. The 22nd is Jean Graham. So thank you.
How about this? Like, what if we did a Sunday? Does it have to be a Friday, or should it? I mean, I don't know. Or
I think it should be a Friday, but since you're doing so well in the, you know, we could have like an hour with Jean,
mm-hmm.
and then we could like to have 15 minutes to just recoup. We could start a little bit later, which seems to work for Filkers.
Yeah, I think so. There's more people out right now. Like, I think Filkers come out at night.
Yeah, so let's see. We're going to start at 8:45 with Jean, and it'll be 9:45, and then we'll take 15 more minutes. So it'll be 10 my time, which will be 8 your time. Yeah.
You what?
So 9, on 9, the 20s.
Wait, aren't you? You're not on daylight savings time, right? And it hasn't ended yet.
We're in Arizona.
I'm still the same time as you right now because of the daylight thing. I don't know when that's ending. I'll have to check.
Okay, Arizona's so it'll be 10 p.m. Central Time.
And it will be 8 p.m. your time, right?
Okay.
Let's see. Is that right, Julia?
Well, let me just double check when daylight savings. Okay. Daylight savings ends November 7th. So, yes, it will definitely be. You're correct, Aya.
Okay.
So, yeah, right. You're right.
So, can you, Leslie, can you put that down in your calendar? The 22nd of October at 8 p.m. Pacific. Or
Arizona standard time.
Yeah.
Pacific the same as Arizona right now, I think.
Yeah, we're the same right now until November 7th.
California
times are so messed up.
Start warning me a week in advance.
Do you text? We could text you.
Nope. Cannot work a phone.
Well, okay. I will email you a week in advance, but you have to clear your email. Can't have 100 emails to go through.
I know. I've got to cut down the feeds that I'm getting. Although as soon as I kill one, another one, they jump up like hydras. You kill one, three more take its place.
I know. A lot of that is spam.
Yeah, they do. That's why I am not a big email person. I try to be, but I'm not the biggest.
That's okay. I can clear an email board. Faster than you'd believe. I just go down the headlines. Spam, ding, ding, spam, ding, ding, ding.
It takes
a bit of time, but a lot quicker than just actually reading the damn things.
I'm putting it in that we're going to be doing this at 8 with Leslie. 8.
Right.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, Leslie. Have a nice evening.
Thank you. And you guys stay well and stay healthy.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Thanks, Leslie.
Good night.
Good night.
How do I turn this?